What is up, guys? Welcome back. Today, I'm going to be giving you my thoughts from the 20th anniversary pin trading celebration, as well as sharing my haul from the event. So if you don't know what this event was, every year Disney does a pin celebration event. Typically this event takes place in person at Epcot and they release special pins that you have to RSP for. You also get special welcome pins. Sometimes there's activity pins and a goodbye pin. And then there's all sorts of cool pin trading and pin boards going on at the event. Unfortunately, like everything else fun and lovely, COVID took that away from us this year. Very sad. We did get a virtual version of this event this year. We're gonna kind of talk about my thoughts on that. First point is the price. Typically this event runs you from $150 to $250, depending on these different tiered packages that they decided they're gonna do now. This event cost you $50. And I will let you know at the end whether I think it was worth it or not. That is definitely much cheaper than $150 plus whatever you're gonna pay for your Epcot ticket, because it does not include entrance into the park. That's its own separate thing. And with that, you got access to the random selection, which is how they decide who gets what pins for the merchandise that's for sale. You got a welcome pin, a goodbye pin, and then access to basically their virtual pin event. In this virtual event, they had live panels with a bunch of really cool, engaging topics focused around pin history. So there was a whole history of pin trading. There was a bunch of artist panels and where they would talk about getting their inspiration for pins. There was one on the whole process of making a pin from start to finish. And I thought these were really cool, actually. I thought they were super engaging. And also, you didn't have to watch them live. They had everything posted afterwards. So I actually watched all of these videos over a couple days on my lunch break. I really enjoyed them. I thought they were really cool. It was a good way to get that content. When you're at the actual live events, a lot of times you're focused on trying to use your pin trading tabs for the pin boards, and you're off trading with other pin traders, or maybe you're just out in Epcot. So at my last pin event, I don't remember hearing or seeing any of these going on. I know they did have panels, but I never took a moment to like stop and sit down and watch them. So I love that they gave it to us in a video format that we could watch at our leisure. And I thought they were produced very well. The commentary flowed very well on them. It was very engaging. I liked it a lot. Now, if you've been to a pin event before at Epcot, or even some of the ones they do at Coronado or at some of the other parks, typically they have boards out displaying different pins that are coming out all over, whether it's Disneyland, Disney World, Disney Studio Store, Mickey of Glendale, or even Shanghai, Hong Kong, so on. And I thought it was really cool this year that they actually had those available as a downloadable PDF. Instead of, you know, having to go and take pictures of all of that, you could just look at the ones that maybe you wanted to share online and you could just download them. Or maybe you could download them, print them out, and circle the ones that you were looking to get in the upcoming year. I also like that they included like different social media logos that you could download. I thought that was just cool, and it made it easier for people who were like trying to share information about the event. I didn't really do any of the like community engagement, posting on any forums. I think I filled out a couple of the polls just to see what other people had put, which was pretty interesting. Things like, you know, what was your first pin event? How many pin events have you attended? So on. So that was kind of cool to see where you fell in there. They also had the badge quest game, which you basically just got badges for, you know, watching a video, commenting on someone's post, filling out a poll, and you could try to collect all of the different badges. I didn't bother with that. I didn't actually watch any of the stuff live either. I watched it throughout the next couple days, which was another bonus. I like that you could go back and watch the information later. Now, of course, as part of the package, you get a welcome pin and a goodbye pin. So I'll go ahead and share those now. We have our little Mickey welcome pin here, and the actual little diamond that he is holding on there actually comes out and is replaceable. And if you did the mystery pack that had the little logos from all of the other pin events, you could actually replace that in there. This was a cool idea and a cool concept. I almost would have rather this have been a separate purchase, maybe for people who were doing that mystery set. I don't know, I would have liked to see something a little more along the lines of the theming rather than just the little 20. Like, I would have been okay with like a pin of just that big little 20. Now, this is still cool, it's cute, it's Mickey, I don't dislike it. I think I was just a little underwhelmed with the welcome pin. And then the goodbye pin, I like the design for, however, I do not love that it is itty bitty. And again, that is because it is supposed to be interchangeable with the little Mickey pin here. You can pull out the logo and put this. And I love that it's, you know, a teaser for next year's pin event. It is the logo, Heroes vs. Villains. So it's got this Steamboat Mickey and then Pete on half of it. Super cute pin. I think it would have been nice to maybe get a full-size pin. And just for reference, I'll go ahead and show you guys what you typically get at these events. And again, this is for a much higher price range, and they're also not having to do things like ship all of these pins because you pick them up at the event. For the animation celebration, this here was the welcome pin, and this is actually a business card for Walt Disney's original animation studio back in Kansas City, Missouri. So I thought this was super cool and like on theme for it. And then what really surprises me is you actually get two other sets, and these ones were included when you do the actual event, and these vary year to year on what you get. So you get this was an activity where you did like some different drawing and whatnot. These pins are a little underwhelming, actually, to be honest, but still cool. It's a whole set, and you get I actually love the boxes that these come in. And then the goodbye set that you got this year was amazing. It's basically Fab Five characters minus Pluto, and they're all doing a different part of the animation process, whether it's storyboarding, ink and painting. I think this set was really, really cool. Overall, I would like to see a little more for this, especially the goodbye pin. Again, cool concept, and I love that it's a teaser for next year's to get us excited, hopefully for an in-person event. Overall, a little underwhelmed with the hello and goodbye pin. Now, as for the rest of the pins available for purchase through the random selection process, I thought there was a really cool kind of mixed bag. I like when, you know, you have a lot of different options, and I think there were a lot of different sets that different people may have prioritized. Typically, there's one or two pins that, you know, really go quick. A lot of people put as their first RSP, and RSP, if you would like me to explain, comment below and I'll make a whole video on how that process works. It is kind of cool, and I do think it's a very fair way, though you don't always end up getting what you want. There was a really good diversity in the types of pins. There were a lot of pins I want. I will share my haul with you in just a moment here. I kept it very modest for me this year. I do like that there were some odes to past pin events. I think it was just a cool way to look back at pin trading, basically. So now I'll go ahead and share my haul, starting with the first item, which is the Magic Band. Now this actually didn't sell out this year, and in past years it typically sold out, but I thought it was really cute this year. I, first off, always love the boxes. The boxes is like one of our favorite things about the Magic Bands, just because they usually have some nice art on them. The Magic Band has basically different iterations of Mickey on it, going kind of through the ages, going around. And then on the back side there, it says celebrating 20 years of Disney pins. And then on the front, you have the 20th anniversary logo. And then the Mickeys are yesterday, today, and tomorrow. So yesterday being black and white. Today is actually more of a yesterday as well. It's kind of the like House of Mouse style Mickey. And then tomorrow is actually our contemporary cartoon style Mickey that you see on the current cartoons. Overall, I like the Magic Band. I think it's super cool. I haven't even activated it or used it in the park, so I don't know what kind of fun things it does. I know the Animation Celebration one, when you tap it to enter the park, does some cool things. Sometimes it'll like flicker different colors and whatnot. The next items I'm going to share are the Yesterday and Today Trifold pins. These pins are super cool. I did not get the Tomorrow one just because the characters didn't appeal to me as much, but it is technically like a set of three that you can get individually. These were $19.99 each, but I really like the old style Mickey one here. And then the purpose of these pins were actually to kind of be a display of the pin making process. So they open up And the first layer is what you see in the completer style of Hidden Mickey pins, where it's an unfilled version. And then you get the kind of rough, soft filled version where you can see that the enamel is dipped. And then the top layer is the final version of the pin. And then going off that is the Today. This is one of my favorite pins from the event. You have the cast of DuckTales on it. And again, it opens up, you have the non-filled version, you have the soft enamel version, and then the hard enamel fill. And then on the back says, enjoying today. Again, limited edition of 750. Just cool pins. I really like these. Again, this is probably my favorite one from the event. Now, the next two I'm going to share were two of the like lithograph style options. This is the print and pin collection that features the animation celebration. Again, that was the pin event that I had attended in person 2 years ago. And it's got a pin very similar to some of the pins that you found at the animation celebration. It's got a little Steamboat Willie on it. They're on a sketch desk. And I don't know, I thought it was just a cool pin, and I always like these like lithograph versions. I've got one hanging up above that set of pins up there from the animation celebration that's got like little sketch Mickeys on it. And the next one from the same set is this current year's version celebrating 20 years of pin trading. The pin is the contemporary style cartoon Mickey. And he's holding the pin trading logo, which is pretty cool. And then behind him is a green emerald because emeralds were 20th anniversary. I also should note a lot of the pins from this event have a little tiny emerald, quote unquote, in them to celebrate the 20th anniversary. So I thought that was a cool touch that they kind of worked them into all the different pins in different ways. And that was my whole haul. Again, very modest this year. Now when I attended the animation celebration, I definitely went quite a little bit crazier. Yeah, a lot more. And you can actually, I have a video of that haul and I'll tag it below. Do I think this was worth the $50? Now again, you spend that $50 just for access to purchase more pins. And many of these pins actually became available at Epcot afterwards. Many are still there at the time of recording this. I would have liked to see maybe some more spectacular pins for the welcome and goodbye. I definitely think they were very lacklustered. Cool designs on both parts. I just was not thrilled with them. I think they could have done something a little bit better on both parts. The RSP pins were good, but there wasn't as much this year that I was like dying to get. I felt like I had to have, but still good. But the virtual content was awesome. That was a big plus that we got this year. I do think it was worth it. Now, I wouldn't want to see this style of event continue. I think many of us do much prefer the in-person event with the in-person trading, the trading boards, and all of that. And if you want to see more of that, I have vlogs covering that event from 2 years ago now. But that was so much fun, and I really hope that next year's event happens in person. Again, heroes versus villains. But if you attended this event and you got some RSP pins, let me know what your favorite pin was and why in the comments below. That's gonna do it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked the video, make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, all of that YouTube fun. And thanks so much for watching, guys. See ya.